it comes down to the simple truth. Not a single image posted by NASA or any other Sith-owned operation or priesthood can be relied on. Instead, we have to rely on the information given by the Allies. And they say we do not see the planets as they really are, and that this war is between God the One and Satan, and God just one. The following information is from the Allies concerning how we make the leap forward. I will still be using some of the NASA images for lack of anything better as representation. The Allies are parked above us. They are not invading aliens. Nibiru is not going to cross. You are not going to die. They are moving you out of the abyss. The Allies say the first thing they will do is rotate Earth to the horizontal position for the purpose of flight. All electricity worldwide will be cut off. In the early morning hours, all life that is good will be given the call. This unplugs them and they wake up and stand up out of their body. This is when the veil lifts and all memory returns. The holographic Skynet will have a hard time keeping up with the roll. This gives the appearance that the sun, which was already rising, falls backwards below the horizon again. As you look to the opposite side of the sky, you will see the net is open inside the dome, and all life on Earth is racing for the doorway there. You are drawn to the positive mass to polarity, and from there you're transferred to the arcs. The seal, which was your choice, determines what arc you go to. This is when the DNA upgrade occurs. It is two streams of code which are merged. One stream is provided by you as you come in, the other stream is provided by the arc. Your mind and your body are altered depending on what branch you chose. You exit the transporter in an incorruptible body suitable to that branch. For instance, if you chose Brahma, you leave that portal as a sentient race of bull. Only those sealed by the One who is God go to the Ark of Man and exit the transport as men. This is why your choice of who sealed you was important. Under the law of free will, only you can correct your choice. Because of the deliberate sabotage, the One says he has never seen so few men's names written in his book of life. This is a staggering loss of children, even the indigos. Every time he went to seal his people, the subconscious mind removed his seal. Because of an oath or vow given to another branch that their conscious mind wasn't even aware had been extracted from them. In order to be sealed by mankind, you have to choose mankind and be sealed by the father of the branch of mankind, who is God. It is only because of these hybrid bodies that we are in that this choice exists. Under normal circumstances, only the father of each branch may seal their own children. Because you are human, you may make a choice. The Allies say they can evacuate all of Earth in under 10 minutes. This is when the net closes again. And then they draw the negative mast. The One will skin the El and the Moloch out of their host bodies. Unwitting followers can be redeemed. But the hierarchy at the top knew full well who they made the blood pact with and why. They are true sociopaths. They enjoyed the slaughter and the profit they gained. They are unredeemable. This is the end of the company store system of Babylon, which is run by the Covens of Azazel under the acronym alias New World Order. The law is nothing of the old may go forward, and this will never happen again. Everything that is evil, corrupted, poisonous, and non-beneficial is drawn to the negative mast. It is transferred to the pot, which is then towed to the pit. The dome is completely cleaned out. The law is nothing evil or corrupt may go through the gate. After they are towed to the pit, He comes back and he tows Earth. As one group, we exit through the gate. On the other side of the gate are laurel whorls. Whorls of green life and great beauty. Once there, Earth's mat is renewed. It goes through the same translation and upgrade. There is a large party with all of the families, and we call this the gathering. After that, mankind settles down on the renewed Earth, and the fifth book of life starts.